Good morning. We are going to start exercise 19C, right? In this exercise, we have some mixed type of question. The first type of question we have is based on general equation. General equation. So let me show you the general form of linear equation. General form of linear equation. Linear equation. This is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is said to be the general form of linear equation. Clear? General form of linear equation where all the terms are written in one side. Is it okay? We have different forms of linear equation. You have already seen. Today we are only talking about the general form of linear equation. So this is the format of general form of linear equation. The advantage of this is that we can also have the slope of a line when it is written in the general form. Clear? In the previous exercise, we have seen if you write the equation in the slope and y-intercept form, it's very easy for us to find out the slope. Likewise, this is also one of the another format, right, where we can have the slope. So if your equation is in the general form, then we can write the slope, right, as like this is minus, we can write, when you write the slope of this equation, right, irrespective of this equation, irrespective of the sign, you in the formula you have a sign minus, right, you have a minus sign. After this you will write the coefficient of, in the numerator we can write coefficient of x, and then this is divided by coefficient of y. So using this concept we can write down the slope if you have your equation in the general form. So for this equation, if I write the slope, then we can have minus, right, in the formula, and then coefficient of x. The coefficient of x is a divided by the coefficient of y, which is b. So this becomes the slope of your given line if it is written in the general form. So we will use this concept and then we will start the exercise. Thank you. We are moving on to question number one. Look at question number one. The question number one says, write down the slope of the following lines. So here we are given total five questions, right? Out of these five questions, I will take two questions. One is Roman number one, another is Roman number five. So I will find out the slope of this two given line. Clear? So your first equation is Roman number one. Roman number one. Your first equation we have is 2x plus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0. This is your equation in the general form and it is already in the complete form. We don't need to do any rectification because all the terms are in one side. We expected this equation to be in the general form. That means we expected all the terms to be in left hand side. Clear? If sometime if all the terms are not in one side, we have to transpose the term and then we have to complete. Now this is your equation in the general form. We have to write the slope. So we will write the slope. Very simple, very minimum calculation. Slope will be equal to minus the coefficient of x. How much? 2. So 2 divided by the coefficient of y. That is plus 3. So 3. That's all. Now this is answer because this cannot be simplified. This cannot be simplified anymore. So this is your answer. So it's a very simple task. Let us take one more question, Roman number 5. Question number 5, we have the equation. The question is 3x plus 4y minus 2 into x plus x1, right? Minus 5 into y plus y1. Y plus y1, and then at the end we have plus 2. This is equal to 0. So this is our equation. Now we have to find the slope, right? In order to find the slope of this equation, right, we have x at several place, y at several place. Is this okay? Therefore, this first of all, it needs to be simplified. It has to be rectified. In this equation, it was simple because you had x at only one place and y also at only one place. Clear? So we could directly take out the value and then we write the answer. We wrote the answer. But in this case, we have to first of all simplify. Clear? So let us first of all operate this, open this bracket and then this bracket. This is 3x plus 4y minus 2x minus 2x1 minus 5y minus 5y1 and plus 2 is equal to 0. Now we have to be very mindful. We will look for only the coefficient of x and the coefficient of y, not any other coefficient. Is it okay? So we will try to write down the term in such a way so that we can have x term, y term, and the constant. Clear? So keeping that in mind, we are going to simplify now. We have 2x term. This will be simplified and it will be made into 1. So 3 minus 2, 1. So this 2 will give you 1x. 1x means x. If you write 1x also, there is no harm. Clear? Next one, y, and then this 5y. Clear? Please do not get mixed up with this 3x, 2x, and then this minus 2x. Okay? This is minus 2x, 1. So this variable is different from this variable. Clear? We want only x. We don't want x1. Clear? Now, 5y minus 5. 4y minus 5y will give you minus y. Because 4 minus 5 is minus 1, and so therefore minus 1y. Now this is also done. Now remaining all that you see, which is not underlined, this term, and this term. Right? Remember, this is very clear. It is constant. No problem. But you will have confusion with this term and then this term. Please do not consider this as x term. Do not consider this as y term. Because this is x1. This is not x. We are only looking for x. Not x1 or x2 or x3. Clear? So this, and this will all go under constant. So we will have this separate. Minus 2x1 minus 5y1 plus 2 is equal to 0. And therefore, this 3 term will be considered as constant. Now, so that is why we are not interested in this part, because we have to write down the slope, and for the slope we need only the coefficient of x and the coefficient of y, not any other term. So now it is ready and we can write down the answer, slope. So slope will be minus the coefficient of x is 1 divided by the coefficient of y minus 1, minus 1. This minus cancel, and your answer is 1 over 1, means it is exactly 1. So this is your answer. Hope I am very clear. So if you, from this question we have learned how to write down the slope if we have our equation in the general form. Right? Thank you. After seeing the application, the use of general form of linear equation, we are now moving to some other applications with the general form of linear equation. So now general form of linear equation is going to be linked with the parallel line and then perpendicular line. Am I very clear? Now, when I talk about the parallel line or the perpendicular line, you know very well what is the condition for the lines to be parallel. If you have two equations, if you are given a pair of equations, then how can you know that the given lines are parallel or perpendicular? Clear? For this, we have to know the condition. And the condition we have already discussed in our previous videos. Once again, I am going to remind you. So, the parallel line condition is the slope of the two lines has to be same. When the slope of two lines are same, then we say that the lines are parallel. Likewise, we have a condition for the lines to be perpendicular, isn't it? And for the lines to be perpendicular, the condition is that the slope of one line has to be the negative reciprocal of the other, right? The slope of one line has to be the negative reciprocal of the other. Then we say that the lines are perpendicular. Or in other languages, if you want to say, we can also say that the product of the two line, if is equal to minus 1, if the product of the two slopes is equal to minus 1, then we say that the lines are perpendicular. So here we have two important things to keep in mind about the, one is the parallel line condition, another is the perpendicular line condition. So parallel line is, even the slope of the two lines are equal, then the lines are said to be parallel. Another perpendicular line condition, perpendicular line condition is when the product of the two slope is equal to minus 1. If the product of two slope is equal to minus 1, we say that the two lines are perpendicular. Or if slope of one line is the negative reciprocal of the other, then also we say that the lines are perpendicular. Am I very clear? So keeping this in mind, we are now going to begin question number 2. Question number 2. In question number 2, we will do both the questions. There are two parts in question number 2, right? So question number 2, solution. First of all, we are going to focus on part 1. Part 1, right? The equation is, one of the equations you are given is k minus 2x, right? Then k plus 3y minus 5 is one of the equation, is one of the equation. Clear? So this is one of the equation. Another equation is 2x minus y plus 7 is equal to 0. Now see the question. Here the two lines are already said parallel. Right? When the two lines are said parallel, what does it mean? It means their slope will be equal. So we will use this concept and we will calculate the value of k. Here we are asked to calculate the value of k if the two lines are parallel. Clear? So what we will do is, we will calculate the slope of this line, we will calculate the slope of this line, and we will equate them because they are said to be parallel, therefore their slope also has to be equal. So by equating the slope of the two lines, we can calculate and get the value of k. Clear? The slope of this line is m1, and this will be minus the coefficient of x, that is k minus 2, divided by coefficient of y, that is k plus 3. Very simple, right? Just limit. Now come to this equation and calculate the slope of this line and then name this slope as m2. Now this is equal to minus the coefficient of x, that is 2, divided by the coefficient of y, that is minus 1. Minus minus cancel, and your answer is 2. So you got the slope of this two line, and these two lines are said to be parallel, right? So the slopes will have to be equal, right? According to parallel line condition, this is notation for parallel line, m1 is equal to m2. Alright, now m1 negative k minus 2 over k plus 3 is equal to 2. Now cross multiply. This minus sign you can take either with the numerator or you can take with the denominator, your wish, right? I'm going to take this minus sign with the numerator. Okay, so this k plus 3 will be multiplied by 2. This implies minus. Okay, now what I can do is, since I'm going to take this minus sign with the numerator, so when I do the cross multiplication, that means same time I'm going to open the bracket. I'm going to open it and then multiply by minus sign. So the sign of this k and minus 2 will change. So this k positive will become negative. And this positive negative 2 will become positive 2. Is equal to 2k plus 6. Now collect the like term. Minus k I will take to right side. Okay. Minus k I will take to right side. So this 2k and this minus k will become plus k is equal to, now this 6 will go to the other side. So 2 minus 6. Minus k shifted to right side and 6 shifted to left side. Clear? So minus k went to right side, it will become positive. 6 coming to left side will become negative. Can you see this? Now simplify. This is 3k is equal to negative 4, and therefore the value of your k is equal to minus 4 over 3. So from this is your answer. For this value of k, these two lines will be parallel. Is it all right? Question number 2, Roman number 2, right? Once again, we have taken the same two equations. In the first part, we took these two equations and then we calculated the value of k for the lines to be parallel, when the two lines were said to be parallel. Now, this time, these two lines are said to be perpendicular. So, if these two lines are perpendicular, what could be the value of k then? So, similarly, we'll first of all find out the slope of these two lines. Let us do that. So, slope of this one is said to be m1 is equal to minus k minus 2, the coefficient of x divided by the coefficient of y, that is k plus 3, same as your previous question. And then the slope of this two also will be calculated same as previous question. This is minus 2 over minus 1, this is equal to 2. So we calculated the slope of these two lines. In the previous question, again I am repeating, in the previous question, these two lines were said to be parallel, and therefore we equated these two and calculated the value of k. Now this time the two lines are said to be perpendicular. So you have to use the perpendicular line condition, and then we can calculate and find the value of k. So perpendicular line condition is perpendicular line condition. You know what it is? Perpendicular line condition is the product of m1 into m2 is equal to negative 1. This is the condition. So we'll use this condition. So we are going to put the value of m1 and m2 in this equation and then solve it, get the value of k. So m1, that is minus k minus 2 divided by k plus 3 into 2 is equal to minus 1. Am I very clear? So I'm going to now simplify. Now when I simplify, first thing what I will do is this minus sign, I will cancel with this minus sign. When I send this minus sign to that side, this side the minus minus will become plus, so therefore automatically it gets cancelled. After this, now you can multiply these two and simplify. So when you're multiplying these two, this is a fraction number and this is a whole number. So you can change this also into fraction number. Now when you have two fraction numbers to multiply, you know that numerator will be multiplied by numerator and denominator will be multiplied by denominator. So use this concept and multiply. It's a very simple task. So 2 into k minus 2. So 2 into k is 2k minus 2 into 2 is 4. Right? And then this k plus 3 into 1 will remain as it is. Right? And then same time I will shift it to the right side. So that side it will be multiplied by 1. So it remains as it is k plus 3. K plus 3. Now we can collect the like term. So 2k, this k will come to left hand side, minus k is equal to this minus 4 will go to that side, will become plus 4, and then this is plus 3. 2k minus k is k, and this is 4 plus 3 is 7. So for this value of k, the same two line will become perpendicular. Hope this task, this question was very simple. Thank you. Now let's move on to question number 3. Question number 3, as you see in the first part, A, prove that the given lines, the given pair of lines are mutually perpendicular. Is it okay? You already know what is the condition for the lines to be perpendicular. So we will use the concept and then we will prove that the two given lines are perpendicular. So let us have the first of all two equation, right? This is 3A. The first equation we have is 3x plus 4y minus 7 is equal to 0. Clear? And another equation is 28x minus 21y plus 50 is equal to 0. You can see how easy question is this. The question is to prove that the given two lines are perpendicular. So if the two lines are perpendicular, the product of the two slope must be equal to minus 1. So we will find out the slope of these two equations and we will multiply. And if the product comes as equal to minus 1, then it will prove that these two lines are perpendicular. So let us find out the slope. This equation and this equation are written in the general form. So how do you write the slope? M1, the slope of this line, is equal to negative the coefficient of x in the numerator, that is 3, and the coefficient of y in the denominator, that is 4. And this is already in the reduced form, so we don't need to simplify anymore. This is the slope of your first line. Now let us find the slope of another line, M2. We will mark the slope of another line as M2. Now minus slope of the first, the coefficient numerator, the coefficient of x, that is 28. And then the coefficient of y in the denominator, minus 21. Now this, there are two negative signs, so this will cancel. It will become positive. Now we can reduce this fraction. The common divisor of this number is 7. 7 3s are 21 and 7 4s are 28. So this fraction comes as equal to 4 over 3. Clear? Now, perpendicular line condition, right? Perpendicular line condition is what? Is M1 into M2 must be equal to minus 1. Let us see whether we are able to get it or not. So, therefore, M1 into M2. Where is it? M1 is minus 3 over 4 and M2 is 4 over 3. Right? This 4 cancels this 4, 4, 1, this will cancel this 1, 1, 1, 1. So, ultimately the whole thing becomes 1. So, this is equal to minus 1. And therefore, the product of the two slope has become equal to minus 1. So, this proves that the two given lines are perpendicular. Clear? So, we can say this proves that the given two lines are perpendicular. Clear? So this is a final answer. Hope it is very clear. This question number 4 also is very similar to question number 3. Here the question is, find the slope of the line which is perpendicular to the given line. Clear? So here we are given one equation, one line. Well, that one line is, given line is 7x plus 11y minus 2 is equal to 0. Is this okay? So now we have to find the slope of a line which is perpendicular to this one. Clear? So what we can do is we will find the slope of this line and we will name this as slope M1. So M1 of this line, slope of this line will be minus the coefficient of x, 7, divided by the coefficient of y, that is 11. And this is also already in the reduced form. It cannot be simplified anymore. So you got the slope of this line. Now you have to find the slope of another line, which is perpendicular to this. Clear? So let the slope of the other line be, let the slope of other line be M2. Clear? Now according to perpendicular line condition, according to perpendicular line condition, right? What? M1 into M2 must be equal to minus 1. Clear? So M1 is given and then you are going to calculate M2 now. You are asked to calculate the slope of another line. So let us use this. M1 is negative 7 over 11 into M2 and this is equal to minus 1. Simplify. This minus is cancelled and therefore your M2 will be equal to, now cross multiply. 11 will go up and 7 will go down. So 11 over 7. So this will be the required slope of the other line. Clear? So if the slope of the other line is this, then this line will be perpendicular to the given line. Am I very clear? Thank you. The question is to find the angle between the two lines. This is type 2 question. Okay, so we need to know the formula for finding the angle between the two lines. So the formula I will give you here. The formula I will give you with a different color. The formula is tan theta is equal to mod of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2. This is the formula we can use. This vertical lines, please remember that this vertical lines is called as absolute value, is called as magnitude of, right? That means the result of this will come out only with the magnitude. There will be no sign. So now to find the angle between the two lines, we need to have the slope of this one and then this one. M1 and M2 are the slope of the two lines. So let us find the slope of this line. M1 is equal to negative 3 over 1. That is equal to negative 3. Clear? This 3 is the coefficient of x and this 1 is the coefficient of y. Now, likewise, the slope of this line, M2, is equal to negative 1 over 2. So you got the slope. Is it okay? Now we are going to find the angle between the two lines. So tan theta is equal to mod of M1 is negative 3. Then minus sign. And then M2 also negative. So minus 1 over 2 divided by 1 plus M1. M1 is negative 3 and M2 is negative half. Negative half. Alright, now simplify. This is negative 3 and this will be positive half. Divided by 1 plus 1 over 3 over 2. Now, next step. Numerator will become minus 6 plus 1 divided by 2. Divided by 2 plus 3 divided by 2. Next step is equal to negative 5 over 2 over 5 over 2. Clear? This number and this number same. The number divided by itself, the answer will be 1. So your result comes as negative 1. Now since this is absolute value, so the sign will be deleted and you will have only the number. So tan theta is equal to 1. So therefore, tan theta is equal to 1. For which angle the theta value is equal to 1? This is the trigonometric ratio of tan, right? So we know that it is tan 45 degree. So for at 45 degree angle of tan, the value is equal to 1. Therefore, theta value is equal to 45. This implies theta is equal to 45 and this becomes the angle between the two lines. Is this very clear? So today we will end the session here itself. You can understand questions and then try to solve by yourself. Okay. I'm not giving you any more assignment. In between there is one or two part of some questions I have left. So that part will be your assignment. Please complete all the questions from question number 1 till question number 5. Thank you. And the remaining questions you will see in the next video. Thank you so much. Take care and study well.